here to give my daughter as a gift to someone close to the throne.
And a dress with real sexy peels.
This is a bag that just goes over the dress.
They're nice.
I really like this.
That they're searching for a lead actress for a big budget Hollywood movie, basically. And I was like, okay, but there is no information. So it sounds weird. And I'm from Eastern Europe. Who's going to call me? Who's going to get me for a big role in Hollywood? Jesus Christ, is it possible? And because this kidnapping problem is a really big issue in Eastern Europe, I was like, no, I'm scared. I'm not going to do it. But I graduated and I was, okay, I have my diploma. I'm officially an actress. And I was, let's record it just for fun. And I recorded it. Probably it was 5, 6 a.m. and I was about to travel for location for another movie that I was shooting in Bulgaria. And I recorded it as a joke, overexcited, but 2 days overexcited as a character. So maybe that's how it matched. And maybe a few hours later, they called me, Julian Kostov, who is my manager and producing partner now. He was like, they want to see more of you. You have to record another one. And I was like, but I'm in the woods. And I was in the woods and I had no service and anything. And I recorded it somehow. And then they flagged me to England. And there I met Sasha and Anthony Hines and Jason Woolner and Dan Mazer. And this whole crazy journey started.
Tell us about your first encounter then with Sasha. He said he was moved to tears when he saw your acting the scene.
So the first time when I saw Sasha was when we were doing for the first time the craziness together. And because he's a genius, this is his game. Like for the last 20 years, I believe with Ali G, it's been the year when I was born, 1996. So he's a master at this. And as far as I know, that they've been searching for an actor that people would not recognize that is an actor. So we started with a couple in England that we tried to make them believe that we are a real family. And it was kind of a funny day. The next thing that we test was our emotional scene, the breakup scene with Tuta and Borat. And at the first draft, I think that's the way it's said, it was kind of a dramatic that probably couldn't fit in the movie that much. And I was, because my background is as a dramatic actress my whole life, it's been like teenage pregnancy or teenager with mental illness or a teenager that is having a transgressive relationship with her father or teenager who is committing suicide. And I was like, okay, this is my thing. I can be dramatic. And probably, I don't know, he might be moved somehow. He might be touched. And that's how he probably believed in me and gave me a hand. And then I was like, okay, here we go. Now it's time to work. And I start learning everything from him, how he's doing it and how serious he is, because he is staying in character all the time and he knows this game perfectly. It's his game. And he also teaches me how to be present in this character, how to go deep inside a character and believe that this person, this Tuta, exists. And I think I also try to like stay in character for a long time. And I remember actually, because in the movie I'm speaking not, and I still have it, I'm speaking with a falsetto, if that's the way it's said in English, with too high voice, like ta 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 ta. And I've been speaking with this voice for maybe 2 years. And when I started seeing my friends, and I was like, "Здрасти, ты поправь," using this voice, and I'm like, "What is happening with you? Why are you speaking like you're in a puppet theater?" I was like, "Oh, Jesus Christ!" And how to explain that is for my part. What is the part for? And the project was still confidential. My parents had no idea what I'm working on until the day when we released the trailer. So it was a weird thing.
Sasha also told us that there were a couple of times during the shooting of the film where he was afraid for his own life. Where did you ever feel a sense of danger also yourself?
I don't think so. I believe the process a lot. And I believe that all of the people, our producer, Monica Levinson, Buddy and Wright, Sky, and Jason, the director, Sasha, Anthony, everybody completely assured me that everything is going to be safe. And because we did everything completely legally, and maybe because of my target of people that I was interviewing and meeting and having scenes with were female. And we're like more vulnerable people when we're more, I don't know, I'm a little bit of a feminist. Not a little bit, but a feminist in a way of that women should be treated equally and we should be given the same opportunities. So my people, that my scenes were not in such a danger. Probably Sasha risked his real life for real and for the cause.
And one more reason why your scene also, which will be passed to history with Rudy Giuliani.
I mean, of course I was nervous, nerve-wracking. I was nervous because I was alone in the scene. Of course, Sasha was 6 feet away from me, not because of COVID, because of the scene. And he was in the closet, ready for saving me and saving the scene and saving the world. But I was alone there. And for me, it was quite challenging because I had to be really, really convincing because I'm not with somebody random and I'm there with a lawyer, with a prison lawyer. So probably as an actor, it was more hard because I didn't want to ruin the scene. I had a duty and I had to handle the scene, and it's important scene for the movie. I'm not American, so I'm not going into American politics more.
And then you called the police. Was that scary?
It was scary, but we were together and it was something legal. So, and we ran away together. And it was really, really joyful.
And what are your goals now? Obviously, you're in Los Angeles. What are your plans and your goals? It sounds like you have fulfilled quite a bit of your dreams.
Yeah, I can't believe it. And I will always be, again, I will always, always, always be grateful for giving this platform and for speaking for the people from my region of the world, and especially my fellow Bulgarians. And what I want now, I want this journey, this dream to keep going. And I believe in dreams, and I believe that people should believe in dreams, because how was it? Walt Disney said it, all of our dreams can come true if we have the willing to pursue them, or something like that. So I'm an optimist. I love people a lot and I love life. I love LA. It's so hot, warm, and people are so open-hearted, open-minded. And I don't know, I just want to work and hope that the projects that I'm joining are going to have impact on the world, because at the end of the day, we're all equals, we're all human beings, and we should support each other every step on the way.